and the wind just tearing me up.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart.
Yeah.
Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I could never explain.
Everyone, if you would please rise.
One look at you, my whole life falls in line. I prayed for you. You.
Everyone, please be seated. Hold hands like you like each other. It'll keep you warmer.
Okay.
Yeah.
Welcome, everyone. Now, this is the time that you have chosen to celebrate your marriage. May you continue to love, grow, and laugh together, because your happy marriage enables you to establish a home with love and stability where your family and friends are always welcome. So remember to do what makes you happy and laugh as much as you breathe and love each other as long as you live. For parents, and I know grandparents on a video, they say when your child finds true love, you find true happiness. May today be the happiest of days. The love that you've created in these two, now create a love that we all share together. Now you two are about to say I do, three little letters, two little words. It's a simple part of the day, but nothing simple about the things that will remain unsaid. I do means I do know I could be hurt, but I'm ready to be healed with you. It means I do want to try, even when fear of failure may hold me back. I'm ready to share your passions, and I do not know our future, but I'm ready to be surprised along the way. I do means I do want your love, and I do give you mine. And nothing we do will ever be the same, because we'll always be doing it together. Do you both continue to pledge to love, cherish, honor, and keep each other safe through good times and bad, in sickness and in health, and trust that you will continue to grow in this loving marriage?
We do.
Greg, if you'd repeat after me to your bride. I, Greg. Invite you to share my life. I promise to always love you.
I promise to always love you.
I will be unselfish.
I will be unselfish.
Kind and trusting. I take you, Ashton. To be my lawful wife. To have and to hold. In tears and in laughter. And from this day. You will never be alone. And the same. I, Ashton. Invite you to share my life. I promise to always love you. I will be unselfish. Kind and trusting. I take you, Greg. To be my lawful husband. To have and to hold. In tears and laughter. And from this day. You will never be alone. Now, real love is something beyond the warmth and glow and the excitement and romance of being deeply in love. It's caring much about the welfare and happiness of your partner as about your own. But real love is not total absorption in each other. It's looking outward in the same direction together. Love makes burdens lighter because you divide them. And it makes joys more intense because you share them. It makes you stronger so you can reach out and become involved in life in many ways you dared never risk alone. May I have the rings, please?
I love you guys. That was good.
Now your wedding ring, thank you, John, is a symbol of eternity. It's that outward sign of your inward spiritual bond which unites your two hearts in endless love. May every glance at your rings bring a smile to your face, but more importantly, a smile in your heart, and remind you of the love and devotion that you promised to each other, not just today, but every day. And now, Greg, as a token of that love and deep desire, please place that onto the finger of your bride and repeat after me. I, Greg. Give you Ashton this ring. As a symbol of my love. And commitment to you. And Ashton, by the same token, onto the finger of your husband. I, Ashton. Give you Greg this ring. As a symbol of my love. And commitment to you. Now you have declared before all of us that you will continue to live in this marriage and made special promises to each other, symbolized by joining hands, taking vows, and exchanging rings. One constant of any wedding, especially a number of them, is advice. So let me be the first to give you the best advice I've ever been given. I asked someone, I said, I do all these weddings. What's the best thing I can tell a couple? And they immediately said, communication. They were a couple that were celebrating their 50th anniversary and we were doing a renewal of vows. And I said, that's perfect. How can I explain it? And she says, well, let me put it this way. My husband bakes bread every Sunday night for our meal and always cuts the first piece and gives it to me. She said it took her 25 years to let him know that she didn't like the end piece. So your thoughts will always be pure and always be for each other. But if they're not said, they may never be heard. So remember to say them every day, especially on the tough ones. Yeah. And remember, you walk hand in hand, because if one walks in front, the other may not follow, and the other walks behind, the other may not lead. But hand in hand, you'll always be friends, always be happy, always be married, and always be in love. So may your mornings bring you joy and your evenings bring you peace. And may your troubles grow few as your blessings increase. And may the saddest day of your future be no worse than the happiest day of your past, and your hands for every clasp and friendship, and your hearts forever joined in love. By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Virginia, I pronounce you again to be husband and wife, and you may kiss your bride. Everyone, it is time to celebrate Mr. and Mrs. Potter.
All right.
Oh, sorry.
See the moonlight shining through the pines, and I know I'm steady on my way. You count no reason for the radio, I'd rather feel the wind and hear the bullfrogs sing. Counting Buddy out towards Monroe said he caught some hawks to trade for moonshine today. There's a party up ahead, an angel to my right. I took my hand and brushed her cheek. When I caught her, I told her, you and I will dance this night away. We will dance this night away. As occasion's on, the bad boys play inside the go-go. We will dance this night. We will dance the night away. All the way. Band was playing, by the time we arrived, she couldn't help but smile. She heard that fiddle play, she'd start to move.